Combustion of wood and any biomass occurs in two steps, flaming combustion and char oxidation. The former occurs in the gas phase and the latter occurs on the surface. Ignition of wood needs a flame to heat up the material till the volatiles are released and a gaseous flame is initiated. Combustion of a wood sphere in air is shown here. The sphere is ignited with a naked flame. After ignition, the sustained combustion occurs because the flame transfers heat to the surface to generate the volatiles that burn in the gas phase. Char oxidation occurs by diffusive transport of oxygen to the surface from the gas phase. Both these are diffusion controlled. Volatile combustion occurs faster than char oxidation. A comparison of the combustion of wood sphere in air and oxygen as the oxidants is shown here. The flame is brighter with oxygen and the wood sphere burns faster and fragments as well because of the sharp heating of the solid. The total combustion time of wood sphere with oxygen is about 16 seconds, whereas the flaming time of wood sphere with air is 20 seconds and the total burn time is 85 seconds. We now look at top lid reverse downdraft gasifier with wood chips and fine biomass as fuels. We also look at actual modern domestic biomass pellet stove. Gasification is a process by which solid or liquid fuel thermally reacting with an oxidizer generates a combustible gas. What you see here is a reverse downdraft gasifier with solid fuel pieces packed into a container from the bottom of which is passed air. Ignition is performed by spraying kerosene on the top layer and lighting the kerosene. The gases generated burn with atmospheric air. In the char mode, the gases are generated at the bottom region and the gases are burnt above it. Note the fine biomass pellet stove functioning here. You can see the hot surface of the combusting fuel. We look at practical gasifier stove. The gasification air comes from the bottom and the combustion air comes from the sides at the top. Look at the outstanding quality of combustion here. Solid propellants are a mix of solid oxidizer like ammonium perchlorate and fuel, aluminum powder, at high solid loading in a binder matrix of a fuel like HDPB or others. A model of solid propellant is a sandwich propellant. The burn rate of a model sandwich propellant is examined at low pressures. These burn rates vary from 1 to 2 millimeters per second. Solid propellant combustion does not need an external oxidizer. A piece of double-based propellant is placed such that it is surrounded by nitrogen. You can see the matchstick flame is extinguished in the nitrogen stream. The propellant is electrically ignited here using a nichrome wire. The propellant burns at about 2.5 mm per second. Solid propellants are designed to burn at very high pressures. They are tested in water known as strand burners. You will see the propellant burning at 10 and 70 atmospheres, at 5 and 17 millimeter per second respectively. A large solid rocket motor on a tester. It burns every second about half a ton of the propellant to produce 1 mega newton of thrust for about 94 seconds. Hybrid rockets are the safest form of rockets. They use a liquid or a gaseous oxidizer and a solid fuel. In the demonstration shown here, a gaseous oxidizer, namely oxygen, and a solid polymeric fuel are used. The rocket motor startup uses an electrically operated pyrotechnic that causes sustained solid propellant burning for a few seconds. Demonstration of a rocket-based human flight.
That's a timer. That's hooked to a buzzer in the back of the helmet here, and we set this for the flight duration. And then when you're halfway through the flight, you get one buzz each second for 5 seconds.
This is to warn you?
Right.
How long does it last up there?
21 and a half seconds.
So if you make a mistake, if you don't hear the buzz, you're really in for it.
Well, you can't miss it. You don't actually hear it, you feel it. It's a vibrator that presses against your skull.
If anything should go wrong, how'd you get down? I mean, is there a parachute harness of any kind?
No, we rely on gravity.
Vishka tube is a tube that converts heat applied in specific locations to sound by creating a self-amplified standing wave. The thermoacoustic interaction is governed by Rayleigh's criterion, which states that the energy introduced into the fluctuating pressure wave must be broadly in phase for the oscillation to amplify. In this experiment with 50 cm long tube, a few pieces of charcoal set on a wire gauze at about quarter of the height of the tube, we brought it to red hot condition with a Bunsen flame. When this flame is withdrawn, the tube starts singing at a frequency, and this frequency can be simply calculated for an open tube as the acoustic speed divided by twice the tube length. A similar experiment with a longer tube. An example of unsteadier pulse combustion can be seen in a bottle with liquid fuel. In the bottle, when the fuel is initially shaken, placed and lit at the top, combustion proceeds in an unsteady mode. Rubin's tube is an example of unsteady combustion. The diffusion flames out of a large number of holes of the tube dance to the acoustic modes generated by the speaker fed with the sound. The fuel gas, which is LPG here, is supplied into the tubes from the other end. The standing pressure waves that change with time in the tube lead to the variation in flow rates from the tubes.